Hey, what's up guys? Stefan here. Today we are back in Logic and I'll be making a dancehall inspired beat. It's been snowing here in London on and off for the last few weeks, so I'm in dire need of some summertime vibes to cheer me up. We'll also be looking at outputs, analog strings, and using NKS ready instruments inside of Logic Pro 10, as mentioned in last week's video. Cool, so let's jump straight in. Today I'm starting with the beat as a sort of precursor to help me capture the vibe and steer me in the right direction from the get-go. Dancehall has a very distinctive rhythm, so I'm doing a typical beat you would hear in dancehall, but with a little bit of a more chilled vibe. Let's quantize that. Now I'm going to use some hi-hats to create another rhythm. We don't want the hi-hats to be straight, as we want to encourage people to dance, move their hips, etc. And again, let's quantize that to put what I've played in time. Cool, so we'll come back to the drums in a moment. For now, let's lay down the main chordal element for the track. And we're using a mallet instrument, as mallet instruments are typically used for this type of sound. To make it sound a little bit more interesting, however, I'm throwing on Halftime by the Cable Guys. It's kind of like gross beat for Logic. It's a really cool effect, but if you want a proper video on this, let me know down in the comment section below and I can definitely bring that for you guys. But as you can hear, it's changed the sound quite a bit. There's a lot more going on both chordal and melodic wise. Now there's freedom in the bass line to do a couple of things. I mean, I could follow the kick drum, but it's quite simple and chilled, so I'm not going to do that this time. Instead, I'm going to play the bass on beats 1 and 3 and just hold the notes. Now to create a little bit more movement down in the low end, I'm going to add an 808 bass to play in conjunction with the synth bass. Now obviously when it comes to mixing and getting them to blend, that's a whole challenge within itself. I've done a small amount of EQ here and there and I think I've got it just okay for YouTube for today. Cool, so whilst you weren't looking, I added a percussion loop and a vocal sample. I'm going to quickly edit the vocal sample, taking out the latter half of it and just looping the first part. If you're struggling to hear it, it's because I've opted to put it way back in the mix. We don't want it to get in the way of the actual vocal. Okay, so to add the finishing touch to this beat, I'm going to pull up Output's analog strings using an instance of Complete Control. Like with Output Signal, which we covered in last week's video, analog strings is NKS ready, meaning it integrates seamlessly with Complete Control and Machine. And as you know, Complete Control integrates seamlessly with Logic. So it's a match made in heaven, a love triangle, if you will. So once again, we can use Native's tag-based browser to pull up analog strings and then narrow down our search and zero in on the type of sound that we want. Cool, so we're going for a plucked string sound again, but 41 results is way too much. So let's narrow it down again and let's narrow it down by mode this time. I really like the mode tag because if you know you're looking for a sound that is arpeggiated or a sequence loop, for example, you can zero straight in on it and cut out all of the noise. And I'm just doing this for analog strings today, but I could use this search parameter across all of my native instrument sounds and NKS ready instruments. It's amazing. But let's go with sequence/loop and see what we can find. We've only got 8 results, so it'll take us only a second to review these. Ooh, indie drama sounds nice. Let's quickly favorite that. Okay, yeah, let's pull up indie drama. As you would have gathered from the name, analog strings provides us with stringed instruments, but of course with a twist. It's built to manipulate string sounds with advanced modulation routing, dual arpeggiators, flux sequencing, and dual tape loopers. Not to mention that the sounds, they're pretty interesting to begin with anyways. They have a unique blend of recorded orchestral instruments, vintage synths, and unconventional elements. So with all of this coupled with it being NKS ready, we've got a pretty powerful instrument on our hands that integrates incredibly well with Logic Pro 10. Now we're going to look at analog strings a bit more in a short moment, but for now let's lay something down and wrap up the bases of this track. Okay, so that's way too loud. Let's turn that down and also quantize it to put it in time. Cool, so that's the basis of the track down. But before we wrap this up, let's take a moment to talk about NKS, the native control standard in which analog strings implements and how it pertains to Logic Pro 10. Being NKS ready, Output has done us a solid in mapping all of the parameters that you would want to adjust and automate on the fly to the 8 encoders on the complete control and machine. Here you can see me adjusting analog strings 4 macro sliders. These are unique to all of the different instruments and command a whole bunch of parameters within the instrument itself, helping us to easily modify our sounds in interesting ways. And we can also change these to command a different set of parameters. Now, if we wanted to automate this inside of Logic, it's super simple. We hit automation, play, and automate on the fly. It's that simple. But we're not just limited to the 4 macro sliders. There's a whole bunch of other parameters we can adjust on the fly. Reverb, arpeggiators, and so much more. I'm going to have a little tinker with this now, but if you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button, drop a comment in the comment section below, and subscribe for more videos just like this. I've been Stefan, and as always, happy beat making.